When Alec was two, he took apart a patio chair with a toy tool because he wanted to see how the chair worked.
Well, I'll just say I've always had a deep interest in figuring out the underlying details of how things work. I first realized that there was something wrong when I was around 11 or 12. I would just lose control of my right hand every once in a while. It slowly progressed to the point where I had a full grand mal seizure.
Epilepsy is a brain disorder in which the brain manifests abnormal electrical activity, not in response to anything.
It set limits on exactly what I know that I can do. There's also side effects that I have from the medication.
It was, let's give this 3 weeks and see if it's working. Let's try another medication. Let's try three. Let's try four.
The goal is to significantly lower the amount of medication that he needs so that he doesn't feel sedated throughout the day. He feels more like himself. He is aspirational and has a lot of goals, and I want to make sure that the medications and seizures don't prevent him from achieving those.
Surgery for epilepsy was historically understood to be finding where in the brain the seizures start and removing that part of the brain.
With Alec, the seizures actually come from the area that controls his hand. So given that, if we were going to go in and take that part of the brain out, that would left his hand not functional.
This bright young man who's a computer coder with aspirations to be a computer scientist and software developer, we were not going to render his right hand non-functional.
I knew the answers were out there if we could find them.
I heard about the RNS from my mother, who had continued to explore alternative approaches to the surgery.
RNS stands for responsive neurostimulation, and it is a device which gets implanted into individuals' brains and skulls to obtain better seizure control.
That completely blew me away because it lined up with exactly what I do every day. It's playing with the technology.
So this is the RNS system. An electrode is going through down into the tissue of the brain. It connects via a very small wire over to the computer chip and battery source here.
They basically drilled a hole into my skull and threaded a few nodes through that and placed them directly on my brain. I walked out of the hospital with a laptop and wand that were dedicated to the transfer of data from my head to that computer to my doctor.
Patients are asked to upload their brain activity to a cloud-based portal where their treating neurologists are able to access that data remotely and begin to train the device to recognize what that individual patient's seizures look like.
I immediately noticed a small decrease in the amount of seizures I was having, and at that point, it was a process of tweaking the algorithm. The best way to describe the way the RNS functions is as a cattle prod.
What it's doing is recognizing that a seizure is happening, and then it delivers those additional stimulations.
First time that I was actually having a seizure and had it stop midway was kind of baffling. See my muscles actually stop moving.
I already know that we're trending in the right direction for lowering his medications.
Has definitely improved my quality of living. The feeling of confidence that comes with being able to have this data has been invaluable.
Somebody who understands technology, that technology is now helping him live his life.
This is AI in medicine at its best, and the outcome is giving young, vibrant people like Alec their life back.